Hi, welcome to Weekly Singapore Stocks with Jonathan. Today is 9 of September 2001, and what a news we had. Uncle Mario Draghi did it. Okay, he basically says he is open for business, in the sense that he announced an outright monetary transactions, and basically he said that it will do an unlimited bond buying provided the country agree to the rules. So in other words, do remember, if you watched the last week video, so right now Uncle Mario is willing to do it, but he's still a virgin. He's willing to do it. Now we just see whether do anyone wants to do it with him. In other words, right now the ball is on the countries who is willing to accept the strict rules. So provided if Spain or Italy or any country wants the bond to be bought by the ECB, they have to agree to give up their powers. That's the whole idea. And the market rallied on Thursday. Dow Jones went up more than 200 over points. And then, together with China announcing the stimulus package, the whole Asia market also rallied. So with Shanghai rallied, Hang Seng rallied, of course Singapore also went up. Okay, so that was the major news of last week. Now, this week, do take note. Oh yeah, by the way, last week on Friday, we also have the non-farm payroll job. Not that good, but Dow Jones still managed to close up 15 points. No change. Now, if you look at it technically, it is no change in a sense that we had a major move on Thursday. It is very common for the bull to take a rest after such a major move. So to us as a technical traders, this is just a rest. That's all. Okay? Now, next week, do take notes. Okay? That next week on Wednesday, Germany will have a court case that will decide whether what Uncle Mario did is is valid or not. Is it legal or not? Okay? This is going to be, could be throwing a curveball to the market. But rumor has it, Reuters did a survey that most probably it will go through because there were some stringent rules that comes with it. So we shall see. Now, FOMC meeting for the very first time, it always starts on Tuesday, ends on Wednesday. But because of this Germany court ruling, they postponed the meeting. And right now, this week, the FOMC meeting will be on Wednesday and Thursday. So that if Germany court do not behave well, FOMC would have a chance to react and maybe say that QE3 is coming. QE3 is coming. That's the idea. Okay? Now, so we shall see. Now, this week, well, this YouTube hopefully should be quite short because one very simple matter. Market rallied. Market already rallied. Okay? So we shall see the look at the chart. Let's take a look at S&P. This is S&P futures, 24 hours. So you notice that we rallied very strongly on Thursday. And then on Friday was a small candle. We now broke this shooting star, okay, no longer valid. And right now, if you've been watching the news, we are at a 4-year high. Okay, Dow Jones is at a 4-year high. Everyone was so euphoric. Everyone say buy, must buy. This is a 4-year high, must buy stocks. Buy anything you want, buy, just buy. The bull is different this time. Just buy stocks. European Uncle Mario Ben Bernanke will not let the market fall just but. Oh yeah, by the way, whatever I shared is just my personal opinion. If you'd like to trade, please consult your authorized broker. Okay? So right now, watch out. Let's take a look at S&P, SPY. Easier to chart this way. Okay? If you take a look at SPY, we are, let's just put it this way. Market is bullish, I agree. We are still in a bull market. It hasn't fallen, but it doesn't mean that one should throw caution to the wind. Reason is because we are now near a trend line. Oops. Okay. If you look at it, we are now very close to a trend line resistance. Okay? So be very careful. So we shall see whether, like it or not, S&P is at a high. Okay? profit taking could be expecting at any time, although previously the profit taking after that shooting star was very small. Okay, after this SPY is a bearish engulfing, very small profit taking before we flew higher. So potentially we can go higher. Now, resistance to watch out for would be at about 145. Okay, 145 is this. Okay, let's draw it. Right here. There's a few support at 145. Now, a minor resistance will be right here. Okay, right there, there will be a minor resistance. We need to clear that shooting star right there. But 145 would be a very strong resistance. So in S&P 500 will be 1450. Okay, now in terms of Euro dollars, of course, rallied after such a good news, has to rally, isn't it? Now, Euro dollar on Friday did a massive run up. US dollars just got crushed on Friday. The funny thing is, US dollar got crushed on Friday. Dow Jones only up 15 points. So something that you have to take note of. And right now, if you take a look at Euro US dollars levels, it is now also at a classical resistance right there. Okay, do take note of that. Now, in terms of gold also rallied. Okay, gold also rallied. So basically, right now, after breakout from this ascending triangle highlighted in the previous YouTube, we have broke out and continue to go even higher. Right now, the next resistance to watch out for would be at about 1780. Okay, next, in terms of Shanghai, of course, Shanghai did a massive rally. And highlighted, if you watch my last week YouTube, watch out for the number 2030. It says 2030 is a support that you have to... can't get the line. Okay, 2030 is a support that you have to pay attention to. Nicely touch the 2030 and rebound off. And this rebound is a very strong rebound because it comes with increasing volume. It got temporarily stopped by the 50-day moving average. So we shall see whether continue to broke higher. First resistance to watch out for would be the 2175, which is a classical resistance right here. Okay, so we shall see whether will we form a higher low. Okay, now next, in terms of Hang Seng nicely hit the 20-day moving average. This 20-day moving average also coincide with the FIBO 61.8% resistance, which also coincide with a classical resistance. So that's why Hang Seng, after a very strong rally within the day, it got stopped by a very strong resistance. So we shall see whether there's a follow through to break up from that resistance. First resistance to watch out for would be the previous high, which is at 20,300, and also there is a psychology resistance at the 20,000 level. So watch out for that. And why did Hang Seng rebound from this level? Very simple fact. I love to trade Hang Seng, one of my favorite indices, and I love windows. Hang Seng love windows. There's a rising window acting as a support right here. Okay, previously there was a rising window right there. It only managed to support it for 2 days before gap down. And now we got supported by another rising window, go higher. Alright, so right now watch out for the resistance at 20,300. Next, in terms of SET, Thailand Stock Exchange had a bearish counter attack candle, okay, on Friday. Well, it's expected because such a gap up, and then people say, well, better get out, take profit, especially weekends, who knows what happened. So right now we shall see if Thailand Stock Exchange can go higher than the Friday's high, then can continue to go even higher. Next, in terms of FBM KLCI, it looks a little bit shaky in FBM KLCI because it did a bearish engulfing candle here, and there was a follow through on Thursday. On Friday, on the bright side, there was two lower shadows, perhaps FBM KLCI trying to rebound. But this type of very strong candle, it is not a surprise, because over here, basically FBM KLCI all just float higher with a small candle. So this is a sign of market getting a little bit jittery. I'm not saying market is going to be bearish. I'm just saying is market is a little bit afraid, jittery, that any bad news they will just run. Okay, so watch out to see if FBM KLCI can break this previous high right here. Okay, 1655. If it starts to form a lower high, may not be a good news. Okay, now in terms of resistance to watch out for, first of all, of course, the 50-day moving average and also the 20-day moving average. And if you notice that the 50-day also coincide with the FIBO 50%, okay, and the 20-day, if we extrapolate it, it will perhaps reach the 61.8%. So be a little bit careful, there could be potential resistance right there. Next, in terms of Straits Times, Straits Times, very simple fact, it bounced, it moved higher, it went higher and now closed at a 50-day moving average. First resistance to watch out for, of course, would be the window right here. This window will also coincide with the 20-day moving average. So be a little bit careful. Now let's see whether the window also have a FIBO. Yeah, it has a FIBO 50% right there. Okay, at the low of that window. So watch out for that resistance. The resistance right now to watch out for would be about 3030, which is a number that came on appearing, to 3040. Okay, 3030 to 3040. These two numbers has been appearing in Straits Times for quite some time. Okay, now in terms of the resistance to watch out for, of course, will be the 3090, the previous high. If we still can go higher, do take note that we have resistance all the way to 3100 because of that falling window. Okay, so a lot of upside resistance. If we go lower, of course, do watch out for, there will be a very strong support at about perhaps 2930, which is actually close to the 100-day and the 200-day moving average, potentially acting as a support. Now, if we still can go lower, these are the levels, 2895, okay, which coincide with the FIBO 50%. So that will be a very good bounce right there, if we go lower. Okay, now basically there's nothing much counter to share, but very simple, it's easy to long right now. Reason is because it's easy to cut loss. Now let me share what I mean. Let's take a few examples like DBS banks. If anyone is thinking about longing, it's actually very simple to long because cut loss, you know, is very clear. Unlike somewhere right here, let's take a look at DBS. You notice that anytime you long right there, it is not easy to cut loss anywhere right here. But right now, because we form a low, anytime, any counter, I'm just using DBS as an example, but any counter you're thinking about longing, do take note, whatever I shared, just my personal opinion, like to trade, please consult authorized broker. Right now, if any counter you want to long, a lot of counter rebounded, the recent low would be your critical support. That's your critical support. For example, DBS, the critical support is $14.12. If you go below $14.12, you got a cut loss on your long position. Okay, OCBC, for example, the recent low was at $9.10. Very nice round number. So if you go below the $9.10, you have to make a decision. Similar like UOB, UOB also the same. So I'm not talking only about banks, but I'm also sharing to say like counters like commodity, like Noble Group, right there. I'm also talking like Olam, right there. I'm also talking like First Resources, right there. I mean, any counter is simple. You look at Marines, you look at basically, everyone just rebounds. Okay, so it's easy to know your critical support right now. So if you want to know long any counter, you just look at the chart, find the recent low, which has happened to be either Thursday or Wednesday. That will be your critical support. It's just so easy. Okay, but do take note, a different market sentiment right now. China is rebounding off the low. Hang Seng is rebounding off the low. Singapore is rebounding off the low. But S&P is still at a high, hasn't yet coming down. So we want to see whether it's Asia stronger or US stronger, or maybe Europe is stronger. Okay, so you have to take note of your risk, especially when this week we're still gonna have a lot of news. Okay, then few counters that you might want to be careful. Capital Mall has a very huge doji on Friday that comes with very high volume, so you have to be a little bit careful if you have long position in Capital Mall. Now if you take a look at Singtel, if you zoom out, it looks very clear. Singtel now has a shoulder, head and a shoulder. Support for Singtel must not break is 328. Singtel must not break the support at 328. Alright, so basically this is what I have to share, because the chart is very simple. If you open up a chart, it's also encouraging you to look at the charts yourself. Cut loss is quite close, and I will have a 2 announcement after I do my usual ending, so watch out for the announcement. If you'd like to find out more, please go to my website chartingacademy.com. Do share my website with your friends so that they know how to watch the video, how to read charts, and perhaps once a while I will put some charts in here. And if you have not joined my mailing list, do join my mailing list because it's free. I do send out market updates. The last update, we predicted a rounding top, nicely break the 3040, and STI broke lower. So those who took that trade benefit a lot from that. Okay, now if you like to find out more about Inner Circle, this is where my Inner Circle information about Inner Circle can be found, right here, where I personally look after a small group of traders, giving them a personal attention with daily market updates and of course daily stocks to look out for. Okay, now coming to that, we have two announcements to be made. Okay, first announcement, three weeks ago, Republican National Congress, they agree to nominate Mitt Romney as their president candidate for elections. Last week, Democratic National Congress agreed that President Obama would be their nominated candidate for the Democratic Party. So in other words, the Republicans have agreed, the Democrats have agreed. So therefore, President nominee Obajon has decided to withdraw from November presidential race, because high probability that if presidential nominee Obajon, if he got elected as president, the whole market will be crashing. Okay, now jokes aside, I've been doing the YouTube for continuously every week over the last 1.5 years. So this would be the last YouTube, not the last YouTube forever. This will be the last YouTube for September. Reason is because I'll be having a 3 weeks break whereby I'll be out from town. Okay, I took a program, a course about 2 years ago, whereby I learned about a spirit of never giving up. And this time I'm volunteering to be a crew. That means crew, volunteer to help out, to help a fresh new batch of people to learn the lesson of never giving up. So I'll be having a break, and where the resort is somewhere in Perak, Lumut Perak. I have no confidence there will be a Wi-Fi, or even if there's a Wi-Fi, the signal will just be too weak to upload this YouTube. So I decided that for the next 3 weeks there will be no YouTube. So the next YouTube will be coming out in October. Okay, so the next 3 weeks, please be safe in your trading, do watch out, and do take notes of anything that can happen to the market, especially when S&P is at a high and there are a lot of news coming out within the next few weeks. Do take note. Okay, so do remember, this is the last YouTube for September. The next YouTube would be in October. I'll be having a 3 weeks break, which means that throughout the 3 weeks I cannot guarantee I will post anything on my website or even my Facebook group. So don't have to visit so much. Okay, I'll be taking a break. Haven't got a break for 1.5 years already. Okay, so be safe, and I'll see you again. Open Gangnam Style.